guys, Ape Winkin, and welcome to Seed Monday. Yeah, it's a Monday, I know. Sorry about that, guys. Sorry, I know it's supposed to be Sundays, but yeah, sometimes that happens. Anyway, so I hope you enjoy the seed. It is beautiful. It is very beautiful. No loot. Sorry, guys, out there, I want loot. This is a beautiful terrain seed, and I mean beautiful. So let's just jump in and have a look at this amazing, beautiful, mountainous seed, shall we? So this seed will spawn you right here in this NPC village, this little testificate village with all your testificate friends and family. And they, of course, will have you got good traits. You'll also have your lovely places to live for the first night and some food. We've got yourself some potatoes, we've got wheat, and we've got carrots. I think they're carrots. Are they carrots? They are potatoes. These aren't carrots? They are potatoes. Where's the carrots? I know there's carrots! There was carrots before! Okay, maybe that's just potatoes. Oh, wait. More. And potatoes. And carrots. There you go. Carrots. See, I knew there was carrots. I knew there was carrots. Of course, you have a load of horses. Well, look at this little baby guy. Oh, look at this. And you got some more horses there. There's loads of sheep as well. And the testicles. But as I say, there's no blacksmith. There's no loot. This isn't a loot seed, guys. This is a terrain seed. And look at the terrain. It is beautiful. We have this huge, sprucey, mountainous area over here, which is all spruce wood and all the, you know, cool Christmas trees. Christmas tree biome. That's beautiful. Over there on the left side here, we've got mountains. Mountainous mountains that will surround your awesome village, which you can start off in. Of course. You've also got these little waterfalls as well, which look pretty damn cool. And you've got some little water pools there as well. So you've got this like little lake that cuts through, which is quite pretty. And of course, these mountains, I mean seriously, these mountains are huge. They are awesome. You could build an entire structure in this. You could build a castle. A mountainous castle. Surrounded, or maybe just one there. Build a castle right there, in the middle. And they have all these mountains around you, which look really awesome. Of course, you can have these little waterfalls as well, which they're quite thin, but quite tall. And you got these ones that just float. Floating waterfalls as well. Why would you not wonder what floating waterfall? You've also got a little snow block here. Oh, look at that. Cute little snow block all on my own. That's really strange. Anyway, over this way we've got more hills and more roaming hills. Roaming hills of beautifulness. You got some forest over that side. So if you want your forest, you've got your beautiful, beautiful forest. And of course, you've got yourself some pigs and all the other cool stuff that you might find on a mountainous biome like this. Lots of food and lots of cool stuff. Now, of course, this is not all about the mountains, guys. I say there are some other things, and that is your plains. Now, if you go over this way, you have your plains biome as well to build. If you don't want to build in mountains, you can build in plains. Some nice flat area to build in. Now, it's not uber flat, but it is quite flat. You've got, like, you know, a bit of flat there. Wouldn't take much to knock that down, make it a bit flatter. Same over this side as well, you can make that quite flat as well. And of course, you've got your mumps as well. If you want to get your horses, you've got your horses. If you want to get your cows, you've got your cows. And if you want to get your sheep, there's loads of spawn. When you start in the village, there's loads there. Go and kill them. Go kill them. And of course, you've got lava here as well. If you want to get yourself some obsidian, quite easy to do. Just come down here, get yourself a diamond. I'm sure you'll be able to find them eventually. And just take away that. And there you go. Obsidian to make your portal to get to the nether. Why not? Why wouldn't you want to go to the nether? It's a beautiful place. Apart from, I hate it. Never going to go again. But still, why wouldn't you want to go? Maybe you're better at survival in the nether than I am. And then once again, you got more forest over here with more hilly biomes over that way. We've got more forest that side. And we got some little cut out in the water again over here. I mean, it's a really, really beautiful seed. I mean, seriously, this is beautiful. I would love to build in something like this. I would build so many structures. I would build a house. I would build a very fine house. It would be the best house in all of the land. The greatest house you have ever seen. It would made be of mud. Dirty mud, glass, and also wooden door. That is my favorite house. That is the best house ever created. Over this side, we've got some swamp as well. So if you want to get your slimes in 1.8, if you generate this world in before, you know, 1.8, generate beforehand, this may be the same terrain. I've never tested 1.8. I don't know. But nevertheless, if you're generating 1.7, then you can get yourself some slimes. And then when you go to 1.8, you've got your slime blocks to get your bouncinesses. Bouncy blocks of awesome. So you got yourself some slime blocks in here, I imagine, after a while. Over the side, we've got some more lava and whatnot. We've got some cutouts in the ground there as well, which I might take down to a hole in the ground. Is this a big hole in the ground or a small hole in the ground? It seems like it might be a big one. Oh, look at it. It's a big one. Look all the way down. You got some creeper. You got a creeper. Hello, creeper. Hey, creeps. How you doing, baby? Are you doing good? You doing good? I'm good. And on the side, we've got some more ores and stuff. I just want to get some ores. You got yourself some ores. More lava there. A bit of water over that side. Quite cool stuff. We're going to go up top side here. Go all the way back up. It takes forever to fly up. I wish you could just fly up as fast as you fall down. It'd be easier. Over this side. Where am I? This way. I want to go. No, that way. Yeah. So over this way. back towards the village where we originally started, which I think was this way. I'm fairly certain. You get yourself a roofed forest over that side as well, so you can get a roofed forest and get yourself some magical areas of roofness. Then you can with the giant mushrooms. You can get yourself a giant mushroom and get yourself a load of mushroom stew. For the rest of your days, you can eat mushroom stew off the giant mushrooms. Unfortunately, there are no mushrooms, which means it might run out after a while. Maybe not the rest of your days. Maybe just the rest of the first day. Just the first day, mushroom stew, as far as the eye can see. Now, over in the village, there is a little bit of a cave system that you can go through as well, which looks pretty damn cool, I must say. So what we're going to do, we're going to check this out. Right next to where you spawn, which you spawned right here, I believe it was right about there. Yeah, I think it was there. I think it was here. Right next to where you spawned, there is this little hole in the ground, and there's two villagers down here already, just having a little natter. Hey guys, you good? You good? And you good? Good. Right, if you come all the way down here, you'll see that we're in a cave system. Now, if you go a little bit to your left, so when you come down, sorry, you go right even, you'll come down and you go into, hello, witch. You go into a ravine. Look at this ravine. Really nice, thin ravine that cuts all the way through the village underneath it. And of course, this little bit here is the, well, that's part of the village. There you go, make that. There you go, another waterfall. Make yourself another waterfall. Why not? You get yourself some more ores in here, some mobs, some cool stuff down there. Some gravel if you want to get some gravel. So not too bad. And of course, you got a lovely witch here. Hello, witchy. How you doing, witchy? You good? Good. And lots of cool other stuff as well that you might want to explore and find on your journey. Now guys, as I say, this is mainly all about the terrain and it looks beautiful. I hope you agree with that statement because I think it looks absolutely phenomenal. I'm just going to fly out the water this way because I can. I'm flying. Look at me. I'm flying. Giant waterfalls, lava falls and more waterfalls over that side and lots of cutouts and terrain and mountains and mobs and awesome things that you may want to build on. So yay. Hope you enjoy the city, guys. Be sure to like, be sure to share, be sure to comment. So be sure to subscribe if you enjoy these videos. I love making them for you. Please subscribe. I love you. Anyway, guys, follow me on Twitter. Follow me on Facebook. Follow me on Instagram. Links in the description. Go check it out. And until next time, TGYL, peace out and bye-bye. Would you believe I've had no coffee today? Well, I had two this morning. Two, but that was like 15 hours ago. 15 hours still riding on that cup of coffee. Anyway, bye, guys. TGYL. Bye. Look at the sun. Look at the sun. Pretty sun. Terrain. Beautiful terrain. I am way too hyped this time of day. Ooh. And what's see Sunday be complete without the amplified section? There we go, it's just joined in. That thing, I was falling through the sky for ages. I thought, well, I'll start. And hopefully, I will get a world generating before I reach the bottom, which it did. Fantastic. So anyway, what would see Sunday be complete with, or see Monday, I guess today, would be complete without the amplified section. That's right, guys, I show you what this world would look like in amplified settings, that setting that we all love, but none of us can play, because it's way too intensive on a computer. So to know who stayed till after credits, who is my favorite subscribers, because they stay, and they love me, and they want to subscribe and be awesome, to give you guys a word. I give you guys a word that you can put in the comments below, and then, you know, put it down there in the comments, and then I'll be a go. You stayed. You're all awesome. Thank you for staying. So this week's word is lightning. The reason for that is we are currently having a major lightning storm outside, and I'm trying to record and not. I'm trying to like edit out any bangs and crashes and thunder. So yeah, hopefully you won't hear any. Anyway, guys. So I hope you enjoyed the seed. You hope you enjoyed what it looked like in normal world. Now look what it looks like in amplified. This thing is huge and amazing. The world, the lovely village here is on the top of a mountain. I mean, seriously, it's a mountain. And I'm lagging a little bit. There we go. And look at this thing. It is so cool. Wow, this really is intensive on the computer. I tell you that. It's like insanely high intensive. Actually, it might be because I'm running 16 chunks at the moment. Maybe I should have reduced the render distance on this thing. That's, yeah, a little bit. Let me just reduce the render distance. Wow, that's a bit high. There we go, 12. 12 chunks. That's a bit better. Maybe that'll load a bit easier. Loading? There we go, it's loading. Great, cool. So, look at this thing in outside. It looks phenomenal. It looks huge and awesome. And these plateaus and the top of the mountains here. I think that's actually maybe the top. No, there's the top there. I was going to say that might be top of the well generation book because it's so flat. But it's not. There's a little bit more on top of that bit. And a bit over there as well. I just realized my F1 menu was totally off. I should probably pack a background, which I did. So as you can see, amazing. Absolutely phenomenal. This, I love amplified settings. They're so beautiful. Just imagine if you built like that castle or something. Build it there. Build it in this thing. This huge and insane awesome thing. Maybe there's maybe that little alcove bit is still there. Let's have a look. Maybe it is. If it is, then you can build it in that little tiny, oh, it is. That little cross section right there. It's loading. There we go. It's loading. And if you just build your little house right there at the bottom of the water here, build it there. Just think, you've got these massive mountains around you. So you could seriously survive. There'd be no mobs attacks because you'd be like surrounded by walls. It'd be awesome. So anyway, guys, this is what it looks like. Amplified, absolutely amazing as always. And you can make some cool things out of this, I imagine. Your computer may not be able to handle it, but it's worth giving it a shot anyway. Anyway, guys, I hope you enjoyed. Be sure to like, share, comment, subscribe, and all that cool stuff. And until next time, I'm going to kill myself, as always. TTYL, peace out, and survival, F5, bye-bye. Toodles! Whee! Falling. Ow. I was wanting to fall for a bit longer. Anyway, guys, bye. Next week, be on a Sunday, hopefully. I'll be away, so I'll get recorded beforehand. I'm at Insomnia. If you're not Insomnia, come and say hello. I'm in Insomnia today. If you're watching it, well, not today. Next week. There you go. Bye, guys.